It's time for another practical success principle. This one is going to make sure that you never, ever piss anybody off. Yeah, good luck with that, right? What I'm going to be telling you today is really, really hard to do. And I'm the first one to know it. But if you listen, you will get so much further in life, especially with people that you just didn't think that you could. So here it is, the big tip, and then I'll explain it a little bit more. Never, never disagree with anybody. Yes, that's what I just said, if you can believe it. And never, never disagree with anybody. And I don't mean you can't disagree with them, but I'm talking about outwardly. And I'm not telling you to kiss butt or anything like that. I'm just telling you, when somebody starts spouting off crazy stuff that you don't agree with, you don't have to rebuttal them. Now, take it from somebody who would always rebuttal anything that was said to me that went against my belief systems. And you know what? It cost me a lot in my life, a lot more than I'll ever, ever know. Sure, I was tactful the way that I would rebuttal and talk back. And in many cases, the people, the way I would say it is, I'm just giving them back my opinion. Well, you know what? And the people would take my opinion and listen to it. But I'm telling you right now, they'll listen to your opinion, but you have just lost influence upon these people. They will not trust you. And if anything, on a subconscious level, if you differ from them, this is one of the laws of influence from Cialdini. Likeability. It's one of the biggest ones. Well, they're all big, but people like people that like them, and people like people who believe the same as them. Now, with that said, I'm not saying you have to agree, and I don't even say you have to say that you agree. I'm going to give you a statement that you can use to basically defuse. Hey, that rhymed. What you can do, and what I do now, is when someone starts talking, the last thing you want to say is, "That's interesting." I hear people say that, and I know instantly, the minute I hear, "That's interesting," that they disagree, but they don't want to say it. Don't ever say, "That's interesting." What you want to say is something like, "You know, a lot of people feel that way. I find a lot of people feel the same way. I find a lot of people feel the same way." And then just shut up. It's like a sales. When you're closing a sales, when you make the closing statement, then you just shut up. They'll talk. So when you say that, just shut up, look at them and smile, and they'll start talking again. And what you always want in a conversation is the other person talking anyway. If you can get people to talk, then you have become a good communicator. The best communicators get other people to talk. They don't sit there and blah, 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 blah. No, they have targeted questions, and I have some for you in the future. I might even bring my favorite question to keep it simple question to keep the conversation flowing, because a lot of people struggle with that. People ask me all the time, "I'm no good. I don't know how to keep a conversation going." It's really not that hard. And with just the one question that I think, yeah, I'm going to bring that one tomorrow. Just one question, you can keep any conversation going. There are more than one, but this one is a great start. And like we always try to do on here, is just keep it simple. One thing at a time, make it your own, and then just keep on improving that character. All right, man, don't disagree. So don't do it, but don't kiss butt either. Just say, "You know, I find that a lot of people feel the same way." Remember that statement. Easy. Practice it and use it. Okay, I'm out of here. Love you, mean it. See ya.